When I have to pick my favorite actors working right now, I generally divide them up into gender and age groups. For example, my favorite actors that are in their 30s would have to be Colin Farrell, Leonardo DiCaprio, and Christian Bale. One of my favorite actors that's in his 40s right now is Philip Seymour Hoffman. The man is one of those brilliant theater actors that finds himself so often before a camera instead of on a stage. He's devoted to theater, even if he's best known as an Oscar-winning leading man and character actor. When I heard he was finally going to direct a film of his own and also star in it, I was interested. That's how I found out about Jack Goes Boating. Jack is the role that Hoffman played on stage as well as in this film. A shy, awkward man in his 40s, living in New York City while working as a limousine driver. He wears his hair in half-finished dreadlocks, listens to reggae music, and doesn't know how to swim or cook. He's set up by his best friend on a blind date and meets Connie, an equally shy and introverted middle-aged woman. They're quiet, they don't know what to say, they're afraid to stick their necks out too far, and they're both urged forward by their friends, who in the story consists of a married couple, Clyde and Lucy. Jack wants to impress Connie, and arranges a date in the upcoming summer where they'll go boating, and before that, he needs to learn how to swim. The film follows these four characters, and the issues of love, relationships, fidelity, friendship, secrets, pride, and guilt are all brought up in a very character-driven story. It's a small film revolving around these four and their problems. It's easy to see this was a theater piece before it was a film. Problems come up, and the ways that they're solved invoke laughter and sighs of disappointment at different times. People have called this slow, boring, tedious. Well, when I watched it in the cinema, I was perhaps the youngest person there by a good 10 years, but there were a lot of people, and many laughed during the comedic moments in the film. But it's hard to say that this is a comedic film or a tragic film. This is a lot like life. Sometimes a person's behavior, or even something as small as an awkward silence, or simple humor can make one laugh. And there are many examples in this film where just the natural behavior of a person can either make you laugh or can make you react otherwise. The actors embody the characters they're playing so much, and because they're all fantastic actors, they carry the story along easily. Most of the cast in it was in the play when they did it on stage. Hoffman, John Ortiz, and Daphne Ruben-Vega are all reprising their characters. Amy Ryan is in the film version, and this should be included amongst her finest work. The whole character of Connie is so brilliantly put, such as in one scene where she is so desperate to do well at her new job that she'll ignore the fact that she was attacked on the subway just to keep working and settle a close. The film has a quirky appeal to it that will either catch your attention or it won't. I certainly liked it, and it made me wonder if I've been forgetting how good theater can be when done right. Maybe I just needed to see it done on a movie screen to realize. And it takes an actor and director of such caliber as Philip Seymour Hoffman to be able to make such a smooth transition from stage to screen. But it's not just Hoffman. It's a quartet of excellent thespians in their prime. The film invites you to laugh, cry, and just share every awkward moment between a group of adults who are still learning life lessons in their autumn years. Lately, I haven't checked to see what age group or what gender watches these reviews most often, so I've probably just alienated a bunch of people who want to see me review a whole different kind of film. But, I mean, this one I saw recently, and it's in the theaters right now, selectively as it is, but it's in the theaters, and I really liked it. I came away with it feeling like I really connected with these characters, even though I'm by far younger than they are, but maybe it'll happen to you too. You never know.